Hi, I'm Heather Penney and I fly Raju Grace, Race 21, and this is Live Air Show TV.
Live Air Show TV's coverage of the 2010 Reno National Championship Air Races and the National Aviation Heritage Invitational is brought to you by Pilot Mag, the future of aviation media.
Like father, like son, John Penney and one of his children give that expression a most unique twist. John and his daughter, Heather, are mirror images of each other in many ways. They're both pilots, and they both like to fly the pylons at Reno.
Well, I grew up here in Reno, actually out in Sparks, and so we were coming to the Reno Air Races ever since I was a little girl and growing up. In 1985, my dad was fortunate enough to become involved with a rare bear team and begin flying with them. So we came to the races every year after that. It's always been my dream to be a race pilot. So when Dean and Raju called me and asked me if I was interested, it was really a dream come true.
Well, we are a sick generation, aren't we? It's the thrill of competition, and to a bigger degree, though, it's the being with the community of people we've gotten to know over the years, the other competitors, the other race pilots. It's a small community, it's like a family, and for the most part, there are no grudges amongst that group of people, and we all love each other, and when we get out there on the race course, our fangs come out.
And they share something else. More on that in a moment. John's racing resume is legendary. He's a four-time unlimited gold champion at Reno in Rare Bear, a highly modified F8F Bearcat. But that's old news to air racing addicts. What's new was Heather making her first foray around the pylons in the faster jet class in 2010.
I'm very fortunate that Dean Barker and Raju Man Ward, they interviewed several pilots who are qualified in the L29. They actually selected me. I was not at the time typed in an L29, but they believed in me, and pretty much from the time they gave me phoned and asked if I was interested, it was 2 weeks later I was getting my type rating, and 2 weeks later I was at the Pylon Racing Seminar.
Talk about a crash course in learning. Pardon the pun. But don't mistake Heather's good fortune coming because of her bloodlines.
My dad flew RF4s with the Reno Air National Guard, and I really always had such admiration for the brotherhood of fighter pilots, the community that they had built, and really the type of aviation, the mission set that they do, and obviously the fighter jets. I fell in love with the Phantom. I mean, it just looked mean, fast, sitting still. As you know, combat aviation was not open to women at the time. I was in graduate school in studying American studies, history, and literature when they opened up combat aviation to women in 1994. I submitted my application to fighter units in the Air National Guard across the nation, and I was fortunate enough to be selected by the DC Air National Guard. They hired me, sent me off to pilot training, and I flew F-16s for the 121st Fighter Squadron for a little over a decade. Flying the race course to me is very similar towards flying a combat mission in that emotion is really compartmentalized out of what you were doing, and what you're really focused on is the task at hand. And so getting on the race course feels very familiar to the type of flying that I did in the military. Not only is it a high demand, high speed, dynamic environment, but also the processes that we go through of compartmentalizing the emotion out of that and really focus on safe, skilled, proficient racing.
The jet class is liberally populated with former Czechoslovakian-built trainers. And though Heather may have been a rookie in the seat of her L29, she's a polished pro when speaking about her plane's specs.
This is a basic Czechoslovakian trainer from the 1950s, so it's a pretty analogous to the basic Air Force trainer, the T-37, that we flew with from the 1950s. So the performance is fairly similar. We race this aircraft at about 7,000 pounds. We get about 1,900 pounds of thrust out of the stock engine. It's an M701C-500, and it's a turbo jet centrifugal flow.
And it's hard to tell who taught whom about extolling the virtues of their plane.
A Rare Bear was a stock Bearcat that Lyle Shelton recovered from a cornfield after an accident at Valparaiso, Indiana from the previous owner. He bought the airplane for $2,500, took it out to Compton, California, and on the bed of a truck and over And during the summer of 1968, he and a bunch of volunteers put the airplane together. The airplane first raced here in 1969. And since that time, the Rare Bear has won more unlimited races here at Reno than any other race plane.
The Penney family is also bonded by a unique and priceless family heirloom.
Well, when my father earned his Air Force pilot wings in 1971, they gave the wives sweetheart pins because the wives were so important to the success of the pilot training candidates. And so when my father went off to Vietnam, he was an A-7 Sandy, so he did a lot of rescue missions in the A-7. My mother had the ring made. She had a jeweler take the posts off, and she wore this ring for years and years. I was a little girl, and I always wanted to be a pilot, and I coveted this ring, and I tried to trade every one of my prized possessions for it. But it wasn't until I earned my wings and graduated from pilot training that she gave it to me. And I've worn it ever since, with the exception of the two combat tours that I did in Iraq, in which case my mom wore the ring for me until I returned.
Neither pilot had huge expectations of winning their class in 2010.
The future of this race team is going to include a bigger motor. We plan on putting a Rolls-Royce Viper engine in next year to be able to almost double the thrust of the aircraft and use that as an opportunity to continue some additional airframe modifications to the airplane. We're very excited, and I believe in Dean and Raju's vision for the team.
Well, we're having a real tough year this year. This engine, Dave Cornell's race engine, is the nicest engine that I've been able to fly behind. We're still fine-tuning. Today is Saturday. We've got to do a test flight. The race this afternoon is going to be a test flight for the boil-off system. I'll tell you what, young Mr. Steve Hinton is just about one of the most talented race pilots out there on a race course right now. I'll tell you what, and he's a fine young man and very humble, and he just goes out, gets in that airplane and flies it the best I've ever seen Strega flown. And he's a true competitor. So, but if we get things sorted out here, our intention is tomorrow to go out and spank that young boy.
Figurative corporal punishment aside, Mother Nature paddled the entire unlimited gold field and sent them to their hangars without supper when high winds forced a cancellation of their race. Heather fared better, finishing third in the jet class silver race. Now we know what question you want asked. Does Daddy want daughter to one day fly Rare Bear?
No, she hasn't flown the Bear, and I'm not sure Daddy would be able to stand that. I mean, it's not to say she's not a capable pilot, but I've been flying this thing for 25 years, and it's a different kind of beast. And I don't know if I could stand the stress of watching my little girl in that airplane.
No, I have not flown the Rare Bear. I don't have the what we call heavy metal, really the World War II warbird experience necessary to be able to step into that aircraft at this time. I love the jet class. It's a growing class. I really love the guys and admire the men that I race with. But I'll be honest, my favorite airplane happens to be the one I'm flying at the time.
In other words, never say never. John and Heather Penney, pilots, air combat veterans, pylon racers. Find another family like that in the world. I dare you. This is Mark Allen, Live Air Show TV.